Coming up, we take a look at what you need to know to prepare for office deployment using System Center Configuration Manager. Now, over this episode and the next, I'm going to walk you through what's different, how to plan for your office deployment, what to do and what not to do, and how to make sure any office add-ins or macros will be compatible, and the prerequisites you'll want to set up prior to creating your office packages. Office is available as part of Office 365 or as part of volume licensing with Office 2019. Now, the Office 365 versions are assigned to users and activation is subscription-based, whereas Office 2019 versions are activated machine-based and use key management services infrastructure via your own servers. Of course, you can continue to use multiple activation keys there as well. Now, for both Office 365 and Office 2019 versions, both use the same application packaging, click to run, and installation approach, and both can be managed via group policy. Now, a common misperception is that all click-to-run packages use subscription activation. Click-to-run versions for Office 2019 apps are offered as well, so not all click-to-run equals subscription activation. Now, with the introduction of Office 365 versions of Office, you no longer have to wait for what was typically 3 years for new capabilities. While Office versions like 2019 and 2016 have had static feature sets over their support lifecycle, Office 365 apps receive continual innovation through monthly or semiannual channel updates. Now, one major difference between Office 365 and Office 2019 releases is that Office 365 versions by default receive monthly feature updates in addition to security and reliability fixes. In fact, there are four different update channels to be aware of. The monthly channel provides users with the newest features of Office as soon as they're available. The semiannual channel delivers new features in Office only a few times a year. Now, there's also a semi-annual channel targeted for pilot users and compatibility testers to test out new semi-annual channel releases in advance, and monthly channel targeted. Now, this is the closest thing to the Insider's release and provides advanced releases of monthly channel builds also for testing. Now, both Office 2019 releases and semi-annual channel releases will receive security and reliability fixes between new releases, but for Office 2019 versions, the feature set is going to be static for the duration of the product lifecycle. Now, to prepare for Office deployment, there are three phases that we're going to cover over the course of our two episodes on preparing for Office deployment and management. Discover, plan, and configure. Now, in this episode, we're going to look at what you need to know to discover your Office estate, including update models, tooling, network optimizations, and everything up until you start to plan for compatibility. Now, typically, Office usage falls into two different categories. General purpose is for the average use case with minimal customizations, COM add-ins or VBA macros that are running on those machines. Now, these are typically the majority of PCs, and it's recommended that these PCs use the monthly channel updates. Now, the other type is business essential. Now, these tend to have more COM add-ins installed and are often for Excel power users where you might have more peace of mind testing and validating feature updates in advance. Now, these PCs can use a semi-annual channel updates to keep feature updates consistent for discovered customizations. To take an inventory of COM add-ins, SCCM 1902 and newer is actually able to enumerate installed Office add-ins. Another option that you can use is the Readiness Toolkit for Office to inventory your COM add-ins. Now, here's where you'll create collections for general purpose and business essential PCs in SCCM like I described earlier. Once your discover steps are complete, you can move on to the plan phase. Now, here's where we're going to look at things like networking considerations, language configs, policies, preferences, app architectures, and compatibility assessment. Let's start with network. So to save internet and VPN traffic while ensuring that your Office installs are kept up to date, you can also choose the direct update distribution of the Office 365 Content Delivery Network, or CDN. And in these cases, if you enable delivery optimization in Windows 10, it allows for peer-to-peer delivery to minimize internet bandwidth usage, so not every client is individually pulling down update payloads. Now, similarly, if you use SCCM infrastructure, you can use peer cache to reduce local or VPN traffic to remote distribution points, and you can enable it very easily in client settings. And with peer cache, you manually define a well-connected client PC on a local network or subnet to cache deployment source. Then Office update files will be pulled from that device. Moving on to languages, if you manage multiple Office languages, you can configure Office installs to have the full or partial languages or proofing language support that you need in the payload. Now, one common mistake here in multilingual environments is building a single package for all users with most or all of the languages for your organization. Now, if too many languages are added, the Office package size can quickly become several gigabytes, as we can see here on the screen. So let's move on to policies and preferences. Office 365 Pro Plus and volume licensing versions of Office 2019 support Active Directory Group policy management, and they use the Office 2016 templates. Now, additionally, install time policy preferences can be configured with the same versions of Office using the new Office customization tool from config.office.com or as part of the Office 365 installer process in SCCM. Now remember, as with the previous Office customization tool for MSI installers, these are preferences and not enforced policies, so what you configure may be changed by the user. Now, a brand new policy enforcement option for Office 365 Pro Plus is the Office Cloud Policy Service, which when configured is simply triggered by users signing into their Office 365 accounts. Now, these policies work regardless of how Office 365 was installed on their machines and whether or not that user's PC is domain joined or otherwise managed. Now, you just need to add users to the Azure AD security group and define the group against the policies that you configure. Now, when the targeted PC connects to the Office 365 account via the internet, policies are then updated and applied to those machines. Now, note here that these policies are currently limited to HKEY current user policies and are not applied to other user profiles on a PC unless those users are also part of the Office 365 groups that you target. Now, let's move on to some Visio and project considerations. So if some of your users have Visio or Project already installed, there are a few things to be aware of. First, volume licensing versions of Visio and Project can coexist on the same computer with subscription activation Office 365 Pro Plus. Second, Visio 2019 and Project 2019, like their Visio Online and Project Online client counterparts, are only packaged using Click to Run. So if they coexist with other Click to Run versions of Office, they need to be at an equivalent version level. Third, if you're using Click to Run packaged versions of Visio or Project, they need to be on the same update channel as each other and as other Click to Run Office install on the same PC. Now finally, the 32-bit and 64-bit architectures or bitness of Visio and Project must match that of other Office suite installs on the same computer or the install will fail as you'll see here. Now related to the installation architecture, if your organization has currently standardized on 32-bit Office and your users have some COM add-ins installed, if you want to go to Office 64-bit, you're going to need to replace native 32-bit COM add-ins with native 64-bit compiled COM add-ins. Now, unlike with Windows on Windows or WoW 64, 64-bit Office does not provide an emulation solution to run 32-bit COM add-ins in 64-bit Office installs. As you can see here in this case, after the architecture migration, the native 32-bit add-in did not load. So now you know how to discover your Office estate, and we've covered the tools, servicing channels, and things to help you with compatibility, how you can set policies and preferences, as well as options for preparing and optimizing your network bandwidth. Next, as part of this prep stage, we're going to cover inventorying, readiness, add-in and macro compatibility, and much more, as well as configuration prerequisites that you'll need to be aware of as part of your Office deployment and management. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you there.